went a-walking one pleasant summer's evening down by the banks of a clear winding stream. In ambush I lay as two lovers they were talking, and clearly the streams they did gently roll. A young sailor standing by, he appeared like a stranger, and he said, "Gentle fair one, I have come from far. But don't be afraid or consider it a danger to walk by the side of a jolly young tar." "Well, indeed then, kind sir, for to tell you quite plainly, the clothing that you wear, they are dear to my heart. For they're like my young Williams, whom I love so dearly, who's crossing the ocean to some foreign part. And what if your William, that you love so dearly, is now joined in wedlock in some foreign clime? And if that be the case, you have lost him forever, so give to me your hand, love, and say you'll be mine. The flowers will decay in the cold stormy weather, and spring's gentle breezes they then will renew. But this heart from my bosom no rifle shall sever, so farewell, my young man, I must bid you adieu." Well, he paused and he gazed with an eye full of pleasure, and the former disguise sure he could no longer hide, till at last he exclaimed, "And joy being a measure, is this my love Jane that I met on the Clyde? For Jane she was to me, since you seem not to know me." And out of his pocket a small bill he drew, saying, "Here's 50 cents as a token I'll give you, since you in my absence have proved loyal and true. And since that kind fortune has brought us together, tomorrow, my darling, I will make you my bride. And you and I, two lovers, we'll never be parted. I'll wed with my Jane that I met on the Clyde."